Hey guys, my name is Nexus, and this is the recorded Manse, made April 1st, 2001. So with that in mind, on with the mission.
After obtaining the spirit stone from the hideout of the resurrection, the keepers naturally want the stone back for safe guarding. But after the ordeal I had to go through to get it, I'd like to find out more about this little artifact and why the keepers are so interested in it. Unlike the sword of Saint Edgar, which was blessed by a Hammerite saint, the spirit stone isn't even of Hammer origin at all. Sources tell me it was discovered in some old tunnels beneath the foundations of a Hammerite factory in some kind of ancient pagan manse. Typical of the Hammers to cover up something like this. Shortly after its discovery, the stone was shipped to a cathedral across town, and there it sat, just waiting for the resurrection to come and steal it. Shortly after that, the factory itself was abandoned to some kind of a disaster. And I'm willing to bet the entire place is haunted. Hopefully, whatever got the Hammers won't get me while I'm down there. Fortunately, the town nearby is still active. An associate of mine works there, and tells me the local weapons dealer is reputed to have some of the best weapons around. I'm probably going to need them. But I don't think a few zombies will be anything that I can't handle.
Okay guys, a little bit difference with all the difficulties. So, let's note, cut purse, 800 in loot required. Rogue, 1700 in loot required. Warrior is different and requires 1200 in loot. So, let's talk about the differences real quick before I get into this. Each one of these has a different starting area. You start from a different point, and there are in fact different areas that you can and cannot go to on each difficulty. So certain areas will be closed off in one and not closed off in another. So with that in mind, we are going to go ahead and go on cut purse first, just to show you what's up, sort of get our bearings, and then I'll be quickly going through the same areas without recording through all the rest of them. I will have you note there is a secret in this that you need to play through all difficulties in order to find out the correct answer. So, with that in mind, let's talk about your equipment. Your equipment is going to matter a lot. We're dealing with a lot of undead, we've got some interesting cash values here. So, I usually go with a couple flash bombs. I'm going to let you know, these are not really going to help you. Healing potion might be useful if you're going to be taking a lot of damage, which on cut first you probably shouldn't be. Mud arrows are pretty cool. There's custom items here, so that's why I'm explaining this. This one is more like a moss arrow in form, but it does mud, so it's visually different. Holy water arrows, we've seen them before. They're pretty simple. Explosive head arrows is basically a fire arrow. Wind arrows. Really weird. You can put out more than one torch with them too, which is pretty cool. So we do have some of those, so I don't usually bother getting those. We don't really need to like kill a lot of undead, honestly. There are some things that are better than others, of course. So really, you just want to make sure that you're spending all your money so that you have something that you can do. Being on this difficulty, we're going to be starting here. So, we start next to a windmill inside the town. Alright. So, let's start working our way out. There are a lot of different areas in this that you can't access in cut purse, unfortunately. A good portion of the story will be unavailable to you as a result of that. Basically, the idea is that the story is different on each difficulty. So it's really interesting. Let's grab these rope arrows. use them in the obvious location, and just sort of hang out up here. Alright. I could have sworn there was something up here. Maybe it's on expert. Might only be on expert. Alright. Good to know, unless it's over there. It could be. Just trying to not kill myself. Oh, yep, see, there they are. I knew there were arrows up there. Could have sworn there was something on that ledge, though. Can you actually grab the rope? Thank you. Alright, so we get some more Razorhead... Well, some Razorhead arrows, actually, because I never bought any. So it's not a huge deal. Honestly, you don't really need to use them too much. They're not useful. I don't want to say that, but honestly, I found that my sword works better. Alright. So we're in a very, very abandoned town. Spider here that I could shoot with an arrow, but I'm really not going to. Just gonna wait. Just gonna wait and use my sword. That is, of course, the one problem, is that I forgot that my sword makes light. I took more damage than I wanted, but that's okay. I'm on cover, so I can afford it. You may notice that the health values are a little bit different. So this is different than on what was medium difficulty, I think. Let's see. That way to the town. I have a map. We start in the mountain pass, technically somewhere around here. The town is down there. Power factory is where we're trying to go. Cathedrals, rock tunnels. So, yep, no more maps. Maps only... The only further maps appear on other difficulties then. Got it. It's actually really interesting how the scripting works for that. It's kind of strange how complicated it can be. This wall right here is not actually here on... Expert, yeah, that one too, I think. So, this is the entrance to the cathedral area. On expert, we would start beyond that gate and make our way into this area. There are enemies out here that are not present currently, but would be present on other difficulties. In a way, we're going backwards. So, I want to note that this log is pickable, and I'm going to pick it because I think there's something in here that I want. But it's also the location of something that we're not going to be using until expert mode. Alright. So, what is all this then? Okay, so there is a secret code. The secret code will, in fact, open that vault. And it will, well, it'll give you something cool. It's not necessary to complete any of the levels on any of the difficulties. It's just there to be awesome. So, anti-mechanist hammerite prototype weapons research facility. Authorized personnel only. The only reason I came here was for that water arrow, because this is not the time to open this vault. Unfortunately, I do not know the code myself. Don't have it written down. Oh, wait. Yes, I do. I did write it down. I totally forgot that I wrote it down. But, I'm still not going to open it, and I'm not going to look at it just yet. I'm not going to look at it until expert, because... Like I said, this is not the time for that. I know what's behind there, and just trust me on that. I'll get to it when I get to it. This area seems brighter than I remember it being. It's also a lot less densely patrolled. Alright, let's try and make our way somewhere without alerting people. Because we are dealing pretty much exclusively with undead here. Alright, you are probably a zombie. I hear that haunt. Not a zombie. Alright. Where, oh, where is it? Coming up behind me? Something really weird with the... Just the way the sound brushes are in here. It kind of messes with my head because they're actually on the level above me. Alrighty. So yes, normally, if you were playing on normal, there'd be... Actually, not sure if you can get in here on normal. I know you can get in here on expert. But I don't remember if it's required on normal. Alright, well, I'm just gonna make my way and try and get people. Taken care of. Hi. I didn't expect that many people to be over here. Yeah, I'm gonna die. I thought there was only one. Probably shouldn't even be trying this right now. No, you can't hit me. I'm supposed to hit you. Okay, good. Good, good. As far as the other guy wasn't alerted. Okay. Got it. Okay, so there are in fact different notes in different categories, but we're kind of going to get an idea of the general gist of what's happening in this place. Don't have the key for this. Don't know if the key exists in this this difficulty. Okay, so just a nice little book letting us know some stuff. More importantly, let's keep going, trying to get rid of everybody in here. Alrighty. Getting a little bit of some weird frames here. Going down those stairs. Don't know what's up with that. You're facing that way, and then you face this way. I need to come up behind him, don't I? Yes. Okay. Let's just keep going. It is actually remarkably pretty. Whoa. I wonder how that's going to show up on the recording. I moved locations, so the fan, when it kicks on, is sort of right next to me now. So I'm not entirely certain how that's going to affect the recording at this point. It shouldn't, but that doesn't mean it won't, so we'll see. There you are. Oh, pressing the wrong buttons. Okay, I just want to know real quick which way you're going to turn. Okay, you do turn back this way. Is this even the same guy I saw? He seems like he's standing in a different look. Okay, you turn every which way. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the same guy. That's weird. How did I see him all the way in there, then? Perspectives, I suppose. Okay, so we're back here, then. Good, good. Can't open the top door. I need a key for that, so let's go back down. Just sort of explore a little bit. This is actually a very nice one. I really don't remember every nook and cranny, which is great. I'm probably going to break every single banner, though. Okay, that scared me. Just a tiny bit. Alright. So, yeah, you saw them turn into haunts. I don't know if that guy patrols before this point, because that's a little bit disconcerting. You're not actually going to be coming this way, are you? Okay, good. You're going to die now. Mostly because I say so. All right, I see that, and I will wait just a moment for that. All right, there's usually a guard there. Know that for a fact. Shiny. Okay, so he's saying, oh, let's do something to encourage attendance. There's nothing too important yet that I have seen. I really feel like I need to summarize for you guys, so really haven't been. That's right. Nope. All right, so there are a lot of custom things going on in here. We've got, you know, custom interesting things. We've got custom models. We've got custom sounds. I haven't seen the custom models too much yet, but I'm pretty sure you guys know that's not the standard zombie groan. I'd like to actually hit the hitbox of the zombie, thanks. Thanks. Just suddenly get launched by a zombie. Totally normal, totally fun. So interesting fact though, for those of you who are unaware, in the original Thief 1, not really in Thief Gold, I think it got fixed by then, if you were standing too close to a zombie when it exploded, you would take damage. A bit of damage, actually. Basically be the same as standing right next to a fire arrow occasionally. So it would kill you just instantly outright, which kind of sucks. It's been fixed completely by New Dark. It just doesn't happen anymore. I'm not really clear on what the difference is that's been done to fix that. I thought there would be something up there. All right. So yeah, let's take a look at all this architecture, because it's really pretty. It's nice. There's varied angles. And then considering the time period, this is probably one of the more intricate missions I've seen. Some of them look a little bit strange, like the columns having that weird circular part, but then it becomes trapezoid. Sure, let's go with that terminology. I feel like you can actually get through there, though that gate isn't there all the time. Not on every difficulty. But for the most part, most of this is the same. It's just the method of how you get here is different. Because certain areas are more available to you earlier or less, etc., etc. Sure are a lot of zombies, though. As a point of fact, I'm not actually worried about the zombies too much. I need to get back in the habit of actually, like, wrecking these things. I haven't actually been fighting too much recently, and I haven't really gotten a chance to play a whole lot of Thief that's, been combat oriented. Okay, I'll deal with that later. Which is honestly a good thing. I've been playing some of the newer missions, which have come out this year, and a little bit of last year's, that I hadn't gotten around to playing yet. Oh yeah, that wind freaks me out sometimes. Neither of you are zombies. Got it. Technically, this guy is not a zombie. Yeah, technically. I think it's just that his corpse doesn't... It's not marked active or alive, so it doesn't really count. Alright, so then this should be where we started, right? Yeah, this is where we started. Awesome. Just got our windmill. The creepy turning slowly. Alright, yeah. Went that way, went that way. Looped back around. And now we're over here. This is going to be a very involved mission, especially since I'm going through the trouble of recording all three different difficulties to some degree. So, this is not where I wanted to go. I wanted to go the other way again. I wanted to explore this area. Where am I? I am getting all turned around. Here we go. This is it. Alright, so that's the power station. Don't really know what's... There's two windmills. Alright, any more zombies over here? Okay, good. Let's see. That is always closed off, I think. And let's see. Mud arrow, 3 diamonds. And if you'll excuse me, I'll just sort of scope that out, because that's there, and I believe I cannot open. Yeah. Okay, so on experts, this door is locked, no way of getting in, and you have to go under and in. On normal, however, that door is unlocked, I think. I thought it would be unlocked in this difficulty too, but that is not the case. Unless it is unlocked in normal, or on expert. Maybe there's a key up front somewhere or something. Different areas is what I'm getting at. Just minor changes that allow you to... Because there's a function in Dramed where you can cause an object to be destroyed depending on the difficulty in which you are in. So, frequently this is the case with empty chests in thief missions that I complain about oh so much. The empty chests frequently actually have to do with a change in the difficulty settings. They'll make it easier to find certain loot, harder to find certain other loot, and then you'll end up with an empty chest because there's nothing else in it. There are ways around that, and I don't like how it was handled in some of the earlier missions. Sometimes they are just empty, but in a couple cases, I've notably stated that they were empty, and, you know, I didn't like that, but it was because of the change in difficulty. Maybe it was expert, and they said, oh, okay, you're on expert. I want you to have harder loot to find. I don't want you to just be able to get it from this chest here, so go find it instead. But instead of putting, say, I don't know, a useless object in the chest that doesn't have a destroy command, they just made it so that it was destroyed. Which is kind of annoying. Okay. So I do have to be a little bit more careful. I can't just go around cutting everybody up thinking that it will work out for me. I want to try and get behind this haunt, but I don't think I'm going to actually be able to manage it, honestly. Because he doesn't turn the correct direction. Man, that zombie skin. Really just... ugh. Nasty. Please, please escort yourself that away. You are gross. And it's interesting how we can have such... you know, considerably low-res effects. Whoops. You can have such low-res effects and have them still be, like, disgusting or scary. Hi. That was interesting. I'm getting launched today. Just a whole bunch of weird model collisions. I wonder if that's because of 1.3, because I haven't had this issue... I haven't had this issue in New Dirt at all with model collisions, really. Where I get launched in the air... because I'm just too close when they stand up or something like that. It happens occasionally, but this is my first time playing an older mission in New Dark 1.23, so we'll see how that goes. Okay. I believe there is occasionally a holy fountain here. And I love how I can state that, though. There is occasionally this here, and it's like something that's a permanent fixture. Occasionally there's a gate here.
I don't care what you hear down there. We post watch for a reason. If thou cannot handle it, thou can be replaced by one of thine brothers with more faith in the builder's power of protection.
Alright, so... corruption in the Hammerites? Who would have guessed? Garrett, why are you trying to swing from the right side? That tells me that there's a model there of an actual, like, being. Alright, smelting is open, and so is whatever this is. West Wing under construction. Alright, given that my sword makes light and occasionally does this where it leaves the light behind. There we go. I was just gonna do that, but usually pulling it out will fix it again. Alright, I gotta think carefully of what the best approach is, but this is probably it, actually. Geothermal energy being harnessed. I see that light in there. This is a bit too bright for me. And that's how we handle that. Alright, so we're in an area with a lot of guards, and I'm gonna be coming through here three different times. And I do mean that. Three times, for each difficulty. There's difference in everything, I suppose. To some degree, it needs to be stated that this is mostly the same on each difficulty. There are minor differences. Lights are different. The lighting changes, I guess. See, this has no effect on this difficulty because the thing it needs to do isn't here. Is this still here on this difficulty? No, okay. This room is usually full of zombies. We can look down in there, see a chest, not too much else. Not a whole lot of patrols on this difficulty, gonna say. It's kind of a good thing, I guess. Sure. Why not? Can I get rid of that? Thanks. I'm just not sure if he patrols on that walkway, too, so I don't really want to deal with that. I can't tell if it's the guy who's upstairs or downstairs, because I can't remember precisely which patrols do and don't, is the issue. Which is a good thing. Means more surprises for you. Oh boy. That's right. There's something here. Something happened here, rather. You go that way. And then you go around. Okay. Usually there are like three different guys patrolling in here, though. So it's kind of difficult to take out these guys without having to deal with, you know. Well, I mean, there's a reason why Expert is called Warrior. To say the least. You're gonna come in this way? Yeah. Alright, that's no good. One moment. Okay, we now have a zombie coming. Sorry about the interruption. Let's see. So, there is actually no way to ever get up there. Those places are not ever open. I've actually cheated to get up there once. There's really nothing up there. So. And actually, I don't even believe that half those doors open, so. Closed for construction! Oh me, oh my. Random hole in the ground for who knows what reason. I'm getting mighty suspicious of something. But I'm not going to share my suspicion. Because it's something that I remember. And I don't want to share that before it happens. Is a zombie coming through the door? Yes. Alright. Ha! Zombie is. Thank you. I'd like to be in darkness. You're just going back through that door? No, you jerk! I want to hit you with my sword. Perfect. Alright. I'll come back here. There's another zombie. He doesn't sound very happy with me. Uh-oh. Problem. I can't tell who's where. Alright. I should be fine. Upstairs? Yeah, this is upstairs. Alright. Okay. So, we have an awful lot of, everything. I'd like to get behind you, thank you. Didn't really help any, but I guess it made me feel better. There we go. I hate when that happens. It's because I'm trying to switch weapons rather than, going to... Not sure if you guys saw that or not. It had a hard time, apparently, deciding which actual item I had. I've noticed that a tiny bit in this new dark. Huh. Alright, well, I'll wait to go upstairs, because I'd like to finish clearing out this level first. Which means going down that way, or going this way. This is actually a very nice area. It does make me think that it would have been built by Hammerites, honestly. It's a very good example of stylized architecture that's also functional. Hard to explain. Like this. This is random. You wouldn't see that most places. But among a group who is doing it because they also consider this a place of worship, totally makes sense. Totally works. He might see that banner is broken. Maybe. He did not. Which means I am free to do this. Oh, alright. Didn't realize I was over here. Alright, first things first. Yeah, first things first. Let's go this way. Okay, so this banner is here, cannot be broken. Wow, I lost a lot of health. When did that happen? Was not paying attention. Alright, well, that's why I picked up one of these. I'm gonna need a lot more on expert, trust me on that one. Yeah, that's there because that's a difficulty banner. That is a banner that only exists because of the difficulty we're in, and it gets destroyed on other difficulties. I do love this water. There's something about it that just is interesting. Okay. Let's just scope out everything. Alright. So she's telling her husband to get the heck out and, you know, don't worry about stuff. I'm leaving, blah, blah, blah. Don't stay here. It's dangerous. Well, she was right. Horribly right. And actually, that is probably her skull or something. The head or... Oh, no, I take that back. There's a baby thing here. Alright. Don't know which conclusion I'm supposed to draw there, but that exists. Alright. What's all this then? Okay, so, fun fact, different difficulty has different things. That note is different on different difficulties. Please save poor Timmy. Poor Timmy's in the closet. Poor Timmy. Let's just leave Timmy. I'd save him, but I'm not exactly a nice person. Let's see. Actually, you can't really save the undead, so I don't know. Can't save Timmy. Very unfortunate turn of events. Alright. Let's go... I'm getting really suspicious of something. Oh yeah, Dolphin Man. Alright. Hey, it's a bonfire. I'm not really sure what purpose that is actually supposed to serve, but in the meantime, we get to see these lovely hanging corpses.
one in Tipo's, one who has sort of... It's lost all its arms and legs. I don't think that's a custom model. I think that's just some manipulation of the models in play, so... That was it. I knew it. I knew it was somewhere in this place. You bastard. Don't you look at me when you're on the ground like that. You stay dead. Unfortunately, I can't close this door now. And unfortunately, that haunt is looking for me. Maybe he'll stop soon. He's kind of confused about what exactly he's looking for, it seems. Unless that's somebody from upstairs. Is that somebody from upstairs? That is somebody from upstairs. Yeah, that is somebody from upstairs. That's not even down here. Alright, got it. So I have actually done everything on this floor. So, if I wanted to, I could just go up this way and do it that way because there's a lovely wooden roof up there. But it wouldn't really help too much, so I'll just go up the stairs. Go up the actual stairs, that is. Okay. Here we go. Stairs. Occasionally, there's a guard here. Instead, he is over here. My bad. Totally wasn't expecting that. You weren't supposed to see me. You jerk. There we go. Anyway, zombies are easy to deal with. Haunts, on the other hand, not so much. Why is it getting brighter? Oh, okay. Alright, let's go this way. Where? Okay. Had to get my bearings straight just a tiny bit. I do have a key. I have the church key. Church key. Is that the one to the top of the cathedral area? It might be. I'm trying to think about that. I'll think about that later, I think, though. I'd like to get to the bottom of this place first. Actually, let me think about that. Find a way through the plant basement into the manse. Steal a pagan tome of spells. Find out what happened in the final hours of the factory. Okay, so if I am going back to the church, I need to go back to the church, like, now. No! Why? Why would you turn around as I'm trying to pick your pocket? You jerk, you're gonna die anyway. Can I have that? Thank you. Alright. Back in business. I don't believe there's any molds in this entire mission, so we can't exactly play around with that. Oh, that's right. We're back here. Cool. Let's take care of this now. Oh, I thought I was gonna hurt myself there. Got it under control. Anyway, it is something weird I've noticed about 1.23 patch. Just seems like I'm colliding more with certain objects or AI occasionally. Their models just not really working out so great. Kind of strange. Where to go? Where to go? Is this not a secret? No, that's open in a different difficulty. Alright, back upstairs. Because I need to locate some things that are not on this side of the factory. I've already been on the other side of the factory. Alright, let's get a move on. Yeah, I'm not even gonna bother trying to hide from him. You can't hit me. Although, it sure would be nice if I could hit you every time. Perfect. Alright, what's up here? Yeah, gross water. That's right. Don't think there's anything on the rafters, so I'm just gonna come back down. Alright, so, luckily we've had this sword the entire time. If we were an expert, man, this wouldn't be fun. We'd have been coming through this without any weapons that would do any damage. Not in a useful manner, anyway. Axis Hearthstone Factory Superintendent, hello. Fun fact, I didn't expect that to happen, but the key is usually over in this location. Anyway, this note. Alright. Good. So, I did just collide with that and go backwards, right? Everybody saw that? Okay, good. That's not just me then. Whoops. That was almost danger. You're gonna turn around. Yep. I didn't really want to do that here, but, well. Hi. No, you don't see me. No, you don't see me. Oh, ow. Well, since the other guy's gonna see me, if I do it that way. Or rather, he's going to get mad, come out, and then see me because I'm an idiot who tries to think I can hide from haunts by standing in the darkness. Yeah, that doesn't work. I don't want to join you. Oh, gee. Okay, thanks.
Come quickly to me! Our brethren are under attack! The walls of the basement have been breached!
Alright, so you guys may be getting an idea of what went on here. Well, you're not supposed to react to that, you jerk. He's gonna come through the door, I know it. Door opens inward. Dang it. No. Yeah, that's my bad. Alright. I don't like this guy. I've never liked him. Never will like him. I could use a mud arrow, but it, gonna be honest, doesn't really help too much. Thing I should do first off, though, is take care of this. But anyway, you guys maybe get an idea of the story that's happening. Something has come up from the basement and caused massive problems for everybody. Everybody's died. This whole town has been overrun with undead, zombies, haunts, everything. Everyone's dead. It's all... Also, interesting point of note, that they're custom skins. Please note that they have upside-down hammers. Go to sleep. Alright. Good. Are we done? No. There's still more. I'll get you later. Alright. I don't believe there's anything actually... Yeah. Although these are unbreakable, there's actually nothing behind them. They're not, you know, they're not unpresent in other difficulties. They're just unbreakable just because... Oh yeah, you. Can you maybe turn around? No, the other way, please. You know, now that I look at him a little bit more closely, he's got a really interesting skin going on there. It's kind of weird how the collar takes part of the chest, though. Never noticed that before. Yeah, I'm just gonna deal with this. No, please hit from the left, not the right, Garrett. Otherwise you'll be hitting the boiler. Thank you. Come again. Alright. Fire time. Yeah, let's roast up some hammerite stew or something. Now we're back here. So, I should have come this way at the first, just to get rid of this guy, but... this works. However... Oh, I can actually pick this lock. Hooray! This is the way you would come up if you were going through the door, I think, and not... Yeah, this is the way through the door and not, as we had to do, which was coming up through the flooded area. Okay, so they're talking about the stone that we were looking for in the first place. They're saying, hey, get it out of here as soon as possible. Well, we all know how well that works. There's never anything in here, though. I'm just sort of going this way to see what I can do. Okay, cool. I do, however, have the factory entrance key, which does this. Hey! Isn't that nice? Factory entrance key also works on the front doors because they are locked currently. So we can get into the atrium. Hey, we've been here. We know what's up. Alright, so now it's time to go actually complete the mission because I haven't done a single objective yet and it's been a while. Let's see, where am I right now? Can you push the buttons? There's no elevator here right now. I don't know why I'm trying to do that. Hey! Okay, yeah, good. Not dead. Glad I'm not dead. Didn't actually expect that to occur. Oh, that's not what I wanted. No, you're not supposed to jump off it. Mantle up there, Garrett. I need to press that button, basically. No, stop. Okay. This is getting ridiculous. Problem is I also can't, like, use any weapons to, open that. Why's everybody freaking out? No. No. Come on, Garrett. You can do it. Come on. Oh, that's frustrating. Alright, I can't take the shortcut, so never mind. Never mind about any of that. I thought I could take the shortcut by going straight down there and pressing the button. You can do that on expert. It seems to not work currently. Possibly because I'm on normal, possibly because of 1.23, because I know I've done it on New Dark. And, it worked just fine. Didn't have so many collision problems. Now I do, so... How do I get downstairs? That's my question. How do I get all the way downstairs? Thinking about where I've been. I'm thinking about where I've been. I'm thinking about where I need to go, and it's not through that door. Where was the basement? Basement. Is there a staircase down somewhere? There might have been. Okay, yeah, there's this staircase. I went everywhere in here, so... And this is just this area. It's not going to help me. Alright, so I need to get down there. How do I get down there from here without having to use the elevator? Because the only way I think I've done it has been the elevator, so... Oops. There's no way here, no there, no... Is it this way? Maybe. Oh, door. Which door is this? I haven't been this way. Did I not go this way? Shut up! Jeez. That scared the crap out of me. I was not expecting that. Alright, so. That poor guy. Let me just try and pick this lock then. Nope. Okay, is this door always closed? Not the church key. Not the entrance key. I have the spirit stone. Been here, been here. There's nothing in there. There's nothing there. Nothing there. then I'm just back around in here. Well, dang, how do I get there if I don't use the elevator then? Pretty sure I gotta use the elevator area. So, that's gonna be an issue. Perfect. Hey, I actually managed to catch myself. Okay. Well, I would save, but, it's generally a bad idea when you fall down a gigantic hole that you can't climb out of. No, Garrett. That's not what I'm asking you to do right now. I'm asking you to actually climb the ledge. Just a tiny bit, because I know you can. Because I've done it before. Can you please? Garrett, can you please? Okay, let's try my cheat button. There we go. Hey! I'm on this ledge now. It's not what happened last time. Can you press the button? There we go. Perfect. I knew I had to do it that way. Alright, so... You know what? I'm just gonna show this off tiny bit. Woo! And it will actually take out a torch at the end of the long line. It's just that there is no torch at the end, so... Yeah. Anyway, I don't know why there's a black hammer right here, but there is. Hello, fan. Thank you for kicking on again. When I least expected it. It's the AC. Climate control. Alright. Actually, you know, I really do not know if you guys can hear that or not, so hopefully you can't. Hopefully I just seem kind of crazy for saying that. Where are you? Where are you? I know that you're here. Okay, you're looking for me. That's why I don't know where you are. Maybe I should just confront him. Maybe later. Alright, some blood here. What's up with that? Some of this. Some of this. Let's go ahead and open this door. Oh, hey, look. There's a whole bunch of coal. Hey, maybe there's a diamond in here. There isn't, actually, but I'm gonna check anyway. Yeah, I didn't think there was. Alright. Well, I guess I'll go this way anyway, because I have no reason not to, really. Good, you're facing the other way. Come on. Swing your... Garrett, why do you make so much noise when you try and heft up your sword? I have no explanation for things. What are you doing? Why are you hitting that statue? That poor defenseless statue. Alright, so anyway, I don't know what's up with some of the twitchiness. Again, I mention this, like, every time. Okay, I'm gonna ignore that. Area closed for construction. Beware, dynamite! You can't actually break this open and get in there because there's a chest in there! And we can do it. I'm not going to right now. Right now, I'm going to say, hey, look at this gigantic blood stain in Matthew Clemens' security supervisor office. Let's go ahead. Okay. You know, I feel like I've actually forgot to mention when I found clues for something. Whoops. That's okay. I'll put it together at the very, very end. I'll put it together, so. No worries. Yeah, they're clues. They aren't, like, directly do this, do that type of things. I mentioned what they were for. They're for that vault we saw at the very, very beginning, which was like, oh, I swear to God, that was like 45 minutes ago, though. Let's see if I could just open this without causing too many. Oh yeah, that's right. This was ludicrously easy to open and also fairly quiet sounding, which was nice. Alright, now we've taken care of all that. We're just gonna go ahead and go this way. Okay, so...
This looks like the way in.
Thank you for the double objective almost sounding. Alright, so we found a way into the basement. We haven't found out what's going on yet. This looks suspicious. It should. It doesn't actually exist in expert or normal, I think. I think it doesn't exist in either, so keep that in mind. Different difficulties mean different things, including different enemies. For example, there's a lot of zombies here. They're not usually here. It's usually haunts. You know, you guys are awfully good at determining when the light's on, when it's to the side of you. You guys have very good peripheral vision for zombies. Stop looking at me, it's really creepy. See, I hate when they do that, but it's awesome at the same time. Nope, come on. Hit. I wish it would stop doing that. Thank you for hitting the correct zombie, Garrett. Alright, let's just go along our way. Alright, yeah, this is still here. More zombies. I have a thing about undead. I don't really like them, so I'm going to just blow them up whenever I see them. Because, hey, why not? Doing the world a favor. Getting paid for it. It's awesome. I still don't have my minimum required loot. How has that happened? I wonder. Although I will say there are different loot requirements on different difficulties. And that's why. Okay, so Shelob over there is the gigantic spider of terror. I hate spiders so much. That one is one that we cannot kill either. At least to my knowledge, that spider has so many hit points that it is incapable of being killed because you just don't have that much equipment and you're probably going to get hit and die before then. But yeah, I think it's an undead spider or something. Kind of cool looking. Keep seeing like some random pop-ups or something. You saw nothing. Alright, that's my loot count. Finally complete. Just gonna take this and eat it. I forgot I was not an expert, so it gives me 4 hit points instead of 2, but that's okay because that's conveniently how many I was missing. Awesome. I'm the best. Got these cool fires here. Got this stupid zombie here. Got that stupid lich over there. And he's not a zombie. He is, in fact, actually more than a zombie. But he'll die just like one, so honestly, it doesn't really matter too much. What's making these lights? Oh, torches. That's right. Well, you know what? Considering I'm not going to be using them anywhere else, sure. That's right. It's magical fire. I don't think that works. I think it works on... You know, I do actually keep forgetting that these are, Hello, sirens. Thank you for scaring me. My new location is now actually, I moved to a different apartment, and it's a lot closer to the fire station than it was. So now everything is nice and loud. Could you not do that? Because it makes it really unpredictable and hard to determine what you're going to be doing. I'm going to wait for that one. I'm going to wait until I can line them up. Just because. Can we not do this song and dance where you keep trying to walk into that, though? Oops. He does actually have the trickster pagan logo on his chest. No, I won't join you now. No, it got stuck. Alright. Well, I can't say I was too terribly surprised by that. Excuse me. Alright. Great is the stone of the beastesses and howls and bloods and cuts that runs red, like hacked fleshes of the forests. Guards forever wheeze the stone that stands reds and pures and life givers to us, like the woodsy lord. Basically, put the redstone here, dummy. Can you go away, please? I wanna hit this guy in the back. Okay, perfect. If you turn around though, I'm gonna be so bad. Alright. Well, we got the book. I don't think we can actually drop the stone there on this difficulty. I'm not actually sure if we ever dropped the stone there. Alright, took care of that zombie. And one moment. Okay, so I have to remember what it is that I was doing before I had to exit the game. Stuff was happening. Alright. I think I just have to go... Yeah, I just have to go find the, exit, pretty much. Which is not down here? I have to go back upstairs for that. Please don't notice me. Alright. Awesome. So... Right? The exit is... Yeah, okay. So on one of these difficulties, the exit is down here. On this difficulty, however, pretty sure it's just back upstairs. That's a really weird noise that I don't remember hearing earlier. Huh. Alright then. I still gotta go back up into the church area, because I need to go find out what happened here, even though I kinda already know at this point, and, yeah, the game doesn't know that I know what's happened here, because it's all supposition. Yeah. Let's go with that word. Can't just go back up that way. Can I, maybe, actually? I have the... do not have a key for this type of thing. I do have the church key, which I never used, so I gotta go use that. So, depending on how long that takes, this may all be cut out. Maybe it won't, maybe it will. Kinda depends. It's probably gonna be cut out, just based on how long this is taking. Mm-hmm. Very long ladder. Yep. Steam. Okay, good. Church. Hang on. What's... is this the non-breakable door? Yeah, the non-breakable door. Church key. Church. Church area was... through... I gotta think about that. Where was the church? How do I get to the church? Church is... not that way. That's how I got into the factory. Hello. I don't know what just happened. Alright then. Right, this way. Like, bounced on that tree somehow. Church. Where is the church? Is this the church? This might be the church. Having trouble remembering where I've been and where I haven't. Hey, it's the church. Church. Still love the music in this. Alright, church, church, church. Church. Let's go. Wow, that's loud. All the way upstairs. This is not the correct direction. Let's see. Wait, no, I can go up this way, right? No, that's where I came from. Okay, that's back down into the factory. I think if I had the key for it, I would be able to come up from that way bottom area through that door. But right now, that's not what I want to do. I want to go upstairs to the way top because I have the key for the way top door that I didn't open earlier because I didn't have the key. But now I do have the key. And now that I have the key, I can go insert key into door slot and turn the lock and then turn the handle at the same time. Can we please get to the door now? Hey, it's a door. Factory basement key. Okay, they're talking about the vault door, and he talked about, oh no, trapped, etc., etc. That's everything, isn't it? Find an exit from the manse. Which is now, so... yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna be moving on to the different difficulties, but real quick, let's check out our stats. Wow, the noise level went down a whole bunch just then for no reason. Alright, so 1239 out of 1304, no secrets found. Guess what, they're all in the vault, I'm pretty sure. So, anyway, next difficulty. Boop! Okay guys, on rogue difficulty, we're gonna go for a bit more of the offensive-defensive things. Let's see. Take two of those, pick one of those, maybe two, sure, why not? We're not really- oh wait, hang on. How much are these again? 250. Just want to make sure I got myself covered. Alright, those are 450. Okay, well, Sure, let's just use up all our money. Okay, cool. So, we start in a different location now. This may be somewhat familiar to you, perhaps, perhaps not. I don't think we really got to come this way, but in terms of the stylistic choice, it's very similar. Alright. So, we are now on rogue difficulty, which has a few differences here and there. Obviously, our start point is one of them. We actually have to go walk up to the town. Kind of. So, we get this lovely entranceway, which, I don't know, I'm kind of fond of this one texture here. I don't really know why, I just kind of am. And there's just little weird secrets here. Some random stuff. Nothing too terribly important, though. This is just a different entranceway to the town. And now we're here, which is the church. And there's no patrolling zombie out here this time. A little bit different. This guy's here now, so we're gonna have some problems. Yeah, that's kind of what I meant. Thought I had waited. Alright, I thought I had waited long enough for him to turn around, just enough for me to actually be able to do that. But, nope. What? You didn't hear anything. So twitchy. You stop being twitchy. I'm crawling on the floor so that you cannot hear me or see me. Thank you. There is a zombie coming up, though. Alright. So, nothing too terribly important. There are fewer haunts in here, so as you can see, it's kind of weird, the difficulty changes. Some stuff is the same, some stuff changes, and some stuff gets less difficult, actually. I'm just trying to get rid of this right now. There we go. Yep, that's the lights. This door is actually open and unlocked, unlike last time. However, that door is still locked. That requires the basement key, which I don't have for obvious reasons. There's a wisp in here now. It's a little bit different. It's kind of strange, and I don't really know how to describe it sometimes. Okay, that note is in fact the exact same thing. No worries there. Alright. So, on Warrior we get most of the... Oh, we can't go up here this time. Alright. Anyway, on Warrior, most of the stuff that you can get to, it's not most of the factory. Like, most of the factory is what gets cut off for you. In this case, it is apparently most of the church and cathedral area that gets cut off. So, for example, reading a book that gives us, you know, pings off one of our objectives, it doesn't really function here in this case. So there has to be a second book in a different area, in which case there is. So we went through here once, and now there's zombies here. Kind of weird, kind of different. I could pick in there, but it's exactly the same as it was last time. No changes in there, I can tell you that right now. We can get up here, though. And I don't remember if there was anything up here or not. I really wish I would stop bouncing off stuff. See, that's something that got fixed a real... Oh, hey, there is stuff up here. Alright, getting hold of some bombs, you say. I wish you would stop doing that, Garrett. Yeah, it seems like I'm bouncing off stuff a lot more than I'm used to. Which, ooh, acid bombs. It's not a good thing, gonna be honest. Not really good at all. Don't know what 1.23 changed, but that's one of the changes I'm not really fond of. Unfortunately, I do have to play it in that occasionally for certain reasons. Kind of. It's always a good idea to keep up to date on the patches, but can be frustrating depending on what changes are made. Especially because some of your customizations that you make to those config files, Well, they go away because you overwrite them when the patch hits, so if you don't, like, keep a line item of what you changed, you're in for some bad times. Alright, so we are back here, and gotta pick this lock again. There's really no reason not to, so just gonna pick the lock. Okay, everything here is exactly the same. Down to the rope arrow, down to the window arrows up there. In fact, it will be the same on every difficulty. And yet, I'm still going to be coming in here and doing it every time. Because I kind of need supplies. Wasn't there, like, a loot pouch up there? Maybe. Maybe. I don't think I'm gonna bother, though. Not unless I'm low on loot, and then I'll come back, probably. Or more likely, I'll just quick go through it, because I've already been through most of this. This was back down to the church, but it's from the other direction. Just wanted to scope this out real quick, because I realized I hadn't gone up there. You're a zombie. Mm-hmm. Alright, most of this stuff is exactly the same, though. Okay, nothing special. Same as last time, same as last time, most of it's the same. There is sort of, it's sort of like, you know, easy, normal, expert, wait, normal, hard, expert? Yes. So normal and expert are way, way different from each other, but hard is pretty similar to both of them. See, I'm really just trying to get them to explode because it makes it so much easier because I don't have to worry about accidentally coming up on them. I don't have to worry about, like, bouncing off them at the wrong time. It's kind of the only reason I do it. There we go. That and it's fun to watch zombies explode. I mean, that's always a plus. So, I don't believe we can go... Nope. Can't just go straight through the front doors. That would be way too easy. Alright. Do we do... Alright. There's diamonds over here or something. Nope. That's a mud arrow. That is not diamonds. My bad. Okay. Door's not open. Door's pickable? Door's pickable. This is different than last time. The door was not pickable last time. I think that's the case. If it's not, then that's my bad for not realizing. I don't... Yeah, see, that's closed now. It's interesting, isn't it? You can change what happens on different difficulties by changing... Well... Okay, so technically speaking, there are two doors there. At any given time, there are two doors. However, you can have a delete object function. Sort of a trigger? Yeah. You have a trigger that basically says, on this difficulty, this is deleted and goes away. So although there are normally two doors there, on hard, there's only one door, you know, because of the way it's got set up. So it's kind of an interesting workaround to that sort of thing. I don't know. I find that thing kind of interesting. All right. Same as last time. So that's actually how they do different objects in different locations. I think I've talked about this with empty chests before. The chest is only empty because the object was deleted. Sometimes I have had both instances where the chest actually was empty for accidental reasons, and also when it was empty because of actual good reasons. Hello, please go away. Thank you. Just wanted to make sure. Okay, that's fine. Ah, see? There's a different. We came through here last time, but now this banner is here. Warning, contents under pressure. Shut off steam valve before proceeding. Hey, we did it. I hear noises. Let's just move this corpse somewhere. Alright. Good, you're gonna go back up there? Okay. Excellent. Why does that keep happening? I'm actually more than a little bit disconcerted about that. See, in the bottom above your light gem, you end up showing things like what you're carrying, random stuff like that, and it seems like when I'm quick saving, it's flashing up like the last thing I had in that slot, or if I had something like a weapon pulled out, or if I had an item I'd just picked up and I saved after hiding it, it keeps bringing it back. It's kind of strange. So if I actually have this out, do that. Okay, well, I guess maybe not this time, but it was doing it, I swear. I noticed it. I don't know if it's going to show up on camera. I really hope it does, actually, because I'd be intrigued. Also, I think I may have alerted the dude who might be in here. Oh, okay. That freaked me out. I thought that was a guy.
Come quickly to me! Our brethren are under attack! The walls of the basement have been breached!
Oh no, the walls of the basement? I haven't heard this story before. Okay. Let's, get on with our lives then. So I could do something about that, but honestly, it's not gonna matter. There's nobody over here, exactly, and also it only really turns off the light in there anyway, so yeah, we're gonna ignore it. So, there's an elevator this time. Interesting, isn't it? Oh yeah, you, again. Wasn't staring straight at it this time. So you may have missed it, but the door got flung open. To Maxis Hearthstone Factory Superintendent. Hey! Alright. Let's read all this stuff. So I actually realized I think I had picked up a secret note to let us know what the code for that one vault is, but I didn't read it because I wasn't paying attention. And you know, I don't always read the readables as I'm going through. Sometimes I read them way later. It's usually because I have read them before and they're usually not too terribly important, even if they're long. Unfortunately, most of them are fluff rather than relevancy, I guess? Yeah. That's what some of it is. Please don't back me into this corner. I don't want to be in it. Thank you. Alright. So, maybe this time I'll brave the waters, because why not? I don't think there's anything down here. Yay, mud arrow! So useful, even though I don't use them. I hardly use any of my supplies ever. There's no real reason for that, just I don't really feel like I need to most of the time, which is kind of a good and a bad thing, because I hate using them, because I always feel like I'm gonna need to save them, but then I end up not needing them, so I don't use them. So yeah. The classic adventurer's conundrum. Alright, we'll get the guy that's coming up here at some point. That bucket is new, isn't it? I don't remember that bucket being here earlier. Perfect. Hi. I only just realized he was there after I had already gone through the door, so wasn't too much point in, Man, you're bad at this. Alright. Well, I'm glad I got that taken care of then. Whew, that was unexpected. You're not coming to investigate, are you? Doesn't sound like it. Okay. Oh, we're over. Huh. So, well, he's over there, which is fine. I just, I didn't really realize I was already here. Man, this place gets me so turned around sometimes. Okay, so I'm gonna go back this way. Hopefully without alerting that guy. I just kind of want to get something from over here. Okay. Good. Still clear. Good to know. On expert, it's full of zombies. So, let's avoid that. Yep. Still trying to avoid getting super heard, but I'm not, like, being incredibly cautious, because otherwise it would take forever. I am now stuck. Oh, there we go. Okay, can't bash these guys, unfortunately. If I do, it's gonna send that whole other room in here. Okay. So, you can see that there are minor differences here and there. Most of the factory level so far has been actually pretty much the same, I'd say. There's a few differences here and there. Minor little details that got changed. It's still very bright. Oh boy, I think I might have hit my mic there, but that's my fault. I knew there was a guy there. No, come back. I want to hit you. I want to kill you all. Well, let's trigger this event then. Can we trigger this event so I don't have to do it later? It's not gonna trigger, is it? That's annoying. Well. Nope. Who's that? Zombie? Yeah, there's a zombie. Man, they make such annoying noises, don't they? This base is all full of pox. Fire engine outside now. I actually wonder if I've managed to set up my mic in such a way that you can't really actually hear that. I would be very pleased if I did, but fat chance of that, so. Okay, 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 okay. Got him. Haha, got him. Alright, I know that you're gonna be investigating with all your investigative powers, but well, why are you? Okay, I was gonna say, if you're coming this way, you are a total jerk. Because you shouldn't be. You shouldn't just know where I am. Oh, there goes the little trigger. Unfortunately. Also, who's running? Yes, your women and children. Man. I don't like that they make foot. See, it did it again! I've been noticing it, but now I like. It's there for a good second or so, so now I'm like actually able to point it out, I feel. Anyway, we've already had one jump scare, so we're probably not gonna see another for a little bit. All the same. I heard a door. Who doored the door? Ah, yes. The elevator. I'll come back to that. You're still here. Same note, actually, now that I think about it. Also the same note. Let's grab all this. You're still not looking so great. Where is that secret document? This is here? Okay. I've got to carefully think about where everything is. So last time we came through here, this door got busted open, and hey, it's still busted open. spooky. See, it's kind of strange because we're technically playing in order, but we're also not playing in order at all. This is the first time we've been here. Oh. Okay, so the objects in this room. Let's talk about this. A bucket, and a broom. So we know that the clue starts with a B for that one vault, because this is what the clue has told us that I just read. Technically speaking, there are two clues per difficulty. However, I've only ever found one on Cutburst difficulty. And I may or may not have actually found it when I went through this time. I wasn't paying attention. So, if I can actually find a condensed list of them, because the only thing I found is people actually high. I totally forgot you would be coming through here. I got so busy talking. Why do I hear it? Yes. Very, very spooky scary. Okay, I was hearing a haunt, so I got really confused and kind of upset. My bad. Anyway, clue. Starts with a B. That is our answer. Starts with a B. God, that would happen too. Really, really scary. Super scary. It's actually... Oh. Really? Why is he following me? He shouldn't be following me. You shouldn't just know where I am. I'm not making that much noise. This must just be his regular patrol route, actually. Yeah, it is. It's this guy again. Don't know why he's so mad. All I did was kill all your friends. Again. I'm probably gonna kill him again. Okay. I just want to be in a spot where I can be in darkness. That's all I ask. Yes. Flames around you. Haha, I can still take your purse. My soul can be saved, you jerk. So rude. No. Alright then. Let's talk about Bobby, Jimmy, Joe, Billy. Is that the same note? Yeah, it's the same note. Also, we can't open that. Ever. I've tried opening it. Bobby, Billy, Susie is in here. Timmy. That was it. Timmy. I knew it was a very stereotypical boy's name. So, yeah, let's go downstairs. In which case, we actually don't need to go down the elevator to do it, because it's totally open. I totally forgot to go this way. That's still not open. Stop your yelling. Stop it. It's spooky. Oh, hey, this is here. The war gauntlets. I forgot about this item. Chop, chop. That? No, okay. All's well that ends well. So if I remember correctly, this item will actually take the place of your sword. So it does slow you down. And, well, it does hurt things. Okay, same note as before. We're gonna now ignore it and continue on our merry way. Do I need to go back upstairs? I probably should. Come to think of it, I want to show off the elevator and what the elevator does and does and do's and stuff. Where's the elevator? Elevator, oh elevator, wherefore art thou? Okay, upstairs. Let's go take the elevator all the way downstairs because we feel like it. Totally not gonna be trying to be scary. I promise, it's just gonna be an elevator ride. It's gonna be awesome. Alright, elevator. Let's go down here. See? I told you nothing would happen.
Oh.
Well. Seems like I bit off more than I could was supposed to. Is this back up? Is it gonna keep doing that, I wonder? Yes, it is going to keep doing that. When I stand on it, it goes down. Huh. Yep. That's your physics lesson. Okay. That's your physics lesson for today. When you stand on elevators, they go down. And when you don't, apparently they have the ability to float. Please do not fall all the way down there, Garrett. You will die. Okay, time to drink a potion. Took some damage, but it was totally worth it. And yeah, I'm pretty sure that's gonna come up on. Yep, that is loud enough to definitely show up in the audio. Thank you, local fire department. We love you for putting out fires. Keep doing what you do. Alright. Enough games, let's go to the area, which is located somewhere. Somewhere in the general vicinity of this area, there is a way downstairs. Let's go there. And hopefully I can... What is happening right now? I'm wondering if it's just me. I'm wondering if it's going to show up on camera too. I feel like this level has gotten very jittery all of a sudden. Where is this? Okay, it's this way. Pretty sure I would lose my own head if it wasn't attached to me. So, fair enough. Alright, doors open. We'll talk about it in a second, I just wanted to check under. I just feel like there's something wrong with how fast I'm going and it makes things feel jittery. I don't know what's up with that. Don't know how I could fix that. Kind of annoying. Alright, what's in here? Okay, different. Alright, so that was another clue. It will keep the wolves at bay if you add a wolf's before it. Okay, that's the same note as before, pretty sure. So if you haven't guessed the password already, please don't spoil it just yet. Very close for construction, beware dynamite. I can break these. There we go! Ha ha! I know I can break them, but I just wanted to get in there and grab that. Alright. Here, nothing up my sleeve. There is one back here somewhere, maybe? Possibly? Hi.
Quietly. I hear something.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if that had, if I'd shown that last time, so I showed it now. And, still no diamonds in here. So, I'm just gonna go.
This looks like the way in.
Alright, we got two ways to go. Which way is the correct way? Steal a book of spells, steal the three sister gems, get 1700 in loot, find an exit. I'm gonna go this way then, because I feel like this was the correct answer to the non-exit area. Yeah. So, differences. No zombies here. Just haunts. Haunts, and more haunts. This Sunday. God damn it. You know, I like that there's like three or four different models of haunts, by the way. It is kind of annoying, but, I like that there's some variety. See, the thing is, though, they're keeping a visual theme between them, which is good. See, when you have a whole bunch of different enemies, but you want there to still be variety in them, you want to keep, like, visual elements the same, because then people will go, yeah, I know how to deal with that enemy. That's one of those red guys. They explode when you kill them. You see where I'm going with this. When you don't have that thematic, consistency between different things, you say, oh, there's red guys that explode, but then there's green guys that explode, too. that can get really confusing to people. And, you know, usually when people say, oh, you know, this game sucks, this game's terrible. Not this one, of course, but when people start saying that, it's usually because of things like that. Inconsistency in, like, game-type enemies. So, for example, there's a giant spider here. I could deal with it. It would handle exactly like I'd be dealing with a regular-sized spider. Actually, there's really no differences between that spider and any other spider, except that it might be undead because of the different color scheme. Maybe. I'm guessing that, based on the color scheme of everything else. I don't actually know, because I've never tested it. But you can kind of determine that reasonably quickly. And, I don't know, it's a good thing. Trust me on that one. If for nothing else, just trust me on the fact that it's a good thing that that exists. And that some people actually bother to do that. Okay. Let's try and, get these torches. Perfect. Can I... might be able to. Well, not that one. You took the place of my blackjack? I mean, to be fair, my blackjack wasn't gonna be seeing a whole lot of use, but I love that blackjack. I'm very visible here. Alright. I'm just trying to put out more than one torch. But, to be fair, I suppose it doesn't actually matter, so I don't know why I'm really bothering a whole bunch. Alright. Good. What's up? Why did you stop pacing? You stopped pacing and I don't know why. You don't usually stop pacing. I'm not going to join you, I will never join you. You are not my father. Alright. Greed is a stone, blah blah blah, it's the same thing we read last time, etc, etc. I love it, but I've already read it once, so I don't wanna read it again for you guys, cause So, this door's here, by the way. That's new. We're gonna go elsewhere, though. Cause, that's not how I wanna go this way. Basically. I could, but I'm not going to. There's reasons for that. I'm pretty sure I'd end up missing... I'm really tempted to taunt that spider, by the way. Just to see. Show it off a little bit. But we'd miss something if I just went through that door and... You know, I don't want to miss things. Not a whole lot of things, anyway. There's some things we can miss because they're the same, and nobody wants to see that again. But for the most part, that's why I'm doing these three different versions, is because, hey, there's three different difficulties, and they're actually different. Alright. Spooky. Alright, we have an apparition. Sort of. I don't want to get too deep into what it actually is. Still very visible. Alright, so there's two of them. Two more of these guys. We're gonna try and ignore them, though. It's actually really not worth my time trying to kill them. Oh, jeez. Now I have to. Okay. Enjoy. Sorry about that, for killing your friend and all. He tried to kill me first. Alright, then. So, where are we? Well, we're here, on this planet, trying to kill people. Well, I mean, not really people, just undead. Also, yeah, they do this when you kill that guy, always, every time, no matter how sneaky you are. Because he makes noise, they wake up immediately, and this is what they do, they try and kill you, there's three of them. I would have liked to have actually, 100% taking care of them, but this is fine too. Shh. Sure. I'll just leave it at that then. That works. Yeah. Okay. Perfect. What's over here? Ah, perfect. Yeah, perfect? Okay, good. Just thinking to myself, you know. What's this? Loot? Okay, treasure awaits us. We must only grasp it with our own hands. Ah, okay. I actually shook my desk when I did that. I knew he was a zombie. I just didn't expect him to get triggered by me taking his purse. All right. Well, all these guys got murdered horribly because it was like they were trying to enact that horror movie. They got chased, they were making a whole bunch of noise, they were arguing. You know, they probably deserved it, but to be fair, nobody deserves a fate like that. What a terrible fate you have met with. Met you with? What? Something along those lines. What does this do? Okay, I don't remember what it does. It doesn't heal you, though, and it's not holy water, so... bear in mind. Maybe, oh maybe, I can find the way to the Promised Land. I don't know what that would be. Oh hey, a library! What's in a library? Lots of stuff. I'm, probably gonna take out the, I don't know what to call those guys. I mean, they're haunts, yes, but... I want to call them something else because they're so cool. Perfect. No witnesses. Okay. Wait, no, okay. Yeah, no witnesses. I'm gonna go with there's nothing actually important here on this difficulty, but I might be wrong. Philosophy of Sung, Poetry of Kital. Might be a reference to something, don't know, don't really matter. Doesn't really matter too terribly much, there's nothing in here. Why is there nothing in here? I don't trust it. I do not trust it, and I don't like it, but I'm pretty sure it's on a different difficulty that there's stuff in here. The thing, yeah. I don't know anymore. Hello. Grar. Right back at you, buddy. Hey, you weren't supposed to know I was there, standing right behind you lurking in the darkness. Okay, so this is back where we were, and we're gonna go this way. Is this? Well, super healing potion. Wind arrows? What's going on here? Blood? Whose blood is this? What is this thing? Etc., etc. She says while knowing full well exactly what it's for and what it does, but I'm pretty sure it doesn't do anything on this difficulty, so. Mmm. Yes. Modern art. Truly. Truly outrageous. I am trying to find things, though. I'm trying to find something specific, aren't I? Empty vial. Perfect. I needed one of those. What's left, actually? Steal the Tome of Spells. I forgot to pick that up. I'll grab that on my way out, I guess. Three Sister Gems. That's a different noise than usual. Hi. Oh no. Oh no. We're not playing this game. Nope. No. I didn't know. No. Nope. Nope. Alright. Don't know where he went. Don't really care right this second. Gonna grab this while I can. Hey, it's not here. Are you gonna be mad if I put this on here? I actually can't put this on here. Never mind. Never mind, I can't even do anything about it. I thought the Book of Spells was still in here. Okay, well, I guess the only thing I can do is try and kill that abomination. Please don't. Kinda gross sounding. Well, alright then. Sure, let's just grab some of this stuff. Nothing else? Okay. He's gonna come back this way though, right? I don't know what noises they used to make him so creepy. But, I feel like they took it from the thing. Some of them. Because they're really creepy, and that's one of the creepier movies I've seen. Oh god, his head is just, ugh. Gross. I can't actually pick that up. Alright. That's fine. I don't know if I'm supposed to be able to pick it up right now anyway, so... sure. As a fun fact, though, we'll get to see him again. You're not supposed to see me until later. Perfect. Kind of. Not really, but that's okay. Alright, so what's this say? Bluesy stone of magic's past rest far away from out of grasp, no walking forward, no breaking step, or falsy man fools to their death. What does it mean? Means this. Means, we get to do some cool stuff. Like this. It's a puzzle. Ooh, boy, it's a puzzle. Okay, let's, carefully. Yep, I just wanna... okay. Perfect. See, when I do puzzles like this, I like to, mark out the corners where I need to turn. Not necessarily the whole path, so kind of saves on time. That's not a corner. Still go forward. Oh, okay, found it. Found it. Found it. Oh. Uh-oh. So, yeah. How about them, local sports team? You know, you look like you're falling down there, so that's kind of disconcerting. But, okay. Oh boy, this is scary. Perfect. Alright, well, we'll grab that in a second. Don't really like how the wind arrows glow, but they do, and there's nothing I can do about that. Whew. Alright, let's leave. You know, I think it actually would have been really neat. Kind of a dick move, but it would be really neat if that floor fell out and everything you had marking the way would just suddenly disappear. You know, way down far, so. Yeah, it'd be awful, but it'd be funny. Where's the... oh, there it is. Fears the light, does the stone of night, it rests not upon its claw, but within the maw of darkness eternal. Oh boy. Fears the light, you say? I was gonna say let's try the obvious. I know that's not actually the answer, though. I was just gonna point out. So, we're gonna keep walking in the darkness. Because that's gonna happen. And, I don't really want to deal with that. Because it's kind of scary. So I'm gonna show you what you're supposed to do instead. Which is... Well, if the stone doesn't like darkness, or it does like darkness and it doesn't like light, So yeah, there's three torches on each side. It's pretty cool actually how this works. I'm not like fully aware of the technical details, but it's kind of neat. Interesting, to say the least. Could you guys stop cackling? Kind of annoying. Got it. Yep. I'm the best thief in the world by traveling in darkness. Alright, I'm just gonna close that door. Okay. Can't open that. Can't open this. And it says, skin of man, skin of beast, the gem of woodsy skin shall burn, and sear your pustulant boils, fearing not the caress of the bottomless boils of crumpling manful fleshes, till baptized in the boiling arms of woodsy magic. Ooh, that sounds gross and disgusting, and I do not want to experience that. Alright. I have all the loot I need, actually. That's pretty cool. I didn't even realize. I wasn't paying attention. Okay, what do I got left, though? Steel. Where's the book of spells, though? Okay. Right. This is this one, not the other one. Got it. Just gonna ignore all that. Hey. That was kind of weird. It was like I got shoved through the door. I have a very sneaking suspicion about this, by the way. Oh yeah, that's right, it hurts. Searing pustulant boils? Oh. Nope, that wasn't it. Oh, that's right. Oh right, I saved right here. That wasn't very smart. Let me rectify that issue. Let me just take care of this first though. You were supposed to take out both torches. You did not, and I'm kind of annoyed now. The wind arrows could use some work. They're actually totally fine. It's just a little bit difficult to aim them because I'm not used to it. Also because they don't really count on these kind of torches, apparently. So we're gonna have thoroughly annoyed them. But in the meantime, I need to go back. Hello. I just hurt myself a tiny bit there. Empty vial. Empty vial. I haven't been in here? Oh. Well, that's new. I didn't really need that, but thanks. Shut up. That's scary. Spooky, scary. Okay, I need to go here. Okay, good. Just checking something. Don't mind me. I need to locate this. Thank you. Ew. Vial of unholy fluid, by the way. We kind of need that, so... Let's go back upstairs. Whee! Ew. Yeah, woodsy magics. That makes total sense that it's unholy water. Yes, unholy water, not holy water. Holy water would be a bad idea here. I don't see anything. You guys are jerks. I don't like you. Okay. Vial of unholy fluid. Thank you.
Alright. That's the last one.
Yep. Somewhere close by, you hear a door opening. Where does the door open? You might ask. I can't pronounce things today. That's what I get for waking up at 7 a.m. on a Saturday. That actually did happen. I had to work today. On a Saturday. Nobody likes working on Saturdays. Okay, yeah, this door. This door is now open. We can, book? Book? Yeah, book? I think book. I think it's book time. Book time? Yeah, book time. Book time? Is book time? It's book time. We get book. We get book, we leave, we go. We may have to sort of book it out of here once we get the book, but book. Yes. Do I have nothing? I have absolutely nothing that will save me from this horrific event. All right. What's over there now? Nothing? Really? That's kind of weird. I was sure there was going to be something. Well, I'm fine with this. So let's just leave. This is the exit. I love how it just makes rainbow striations everywhere. I don't really know what does that, but I think it's cool. Hey, objective complete! Yay, it's the end! Okay, so the ending is exactly the same as last one's. This one took us a lot less time. I think I didn't pay attention last time either. 2,500 out of 2,600 or so. No secrets found still. We'll get to it. Okay, so on to the next difficulty. Okay, so warrior difficulty, little bit different. I'm still gonna be taking a healing potion just in case. I'm still gonna be taking these, and I'm probably... Ooh, that's a good question. What do I need for that one guy? I have to actually think about this now. No, I can get plenty of those. I should probably take another one of these. You should take some of these. Oh, that's way too expensive. I'm not taking that. It's dumb. I'm not gonna use that. Who uses that? Sure. Okay, so we get to start in a different area entirely now. I actually like this difficulty's start place the best. I don't know why, but there's something about the weirdness of this sort of structure here that I just really like. It appeals to me. I don't have to defend my likes to you. Alright, dead guy. Dead guy doesn't have too much to say, but he does have some wind arrows right off the bat. For the most part, I don't think I've ever bought wind arrows, really, because, you know, they're kind of everywhere. Let's just get going. So it seems to me like this was sort of the original idea. And I only say that because of how much... I can't pronounce things today. How much more polished it is. I don't know, there's just something about it that feels like it's different. Anyway, we can't really go that way, unfortunately. So, let's continue. We got this lovely view, though. There's just something about this difficulty's sort of lead-in to the actual town that makes me think that this should have been how it always was. Like, it's hard to explain because you are supposed to go through every difficulty, and that can be tedious. I'll grant you that. It can be very tedious, but I don't know. I kind of enjoy it. So, anyway, we're actually going to open this right now rather than later. I may find the actual clue that might help you, but I'm not going to really, like... wait until then, because I already know the answer. So, I guessed the clue immediately my first time through upon hearing that clue from the middle difficulty, the second one we found. Knowing that it started with a B was probably part of helping that, though. So, the thing is, you know, you add the code to wolves to, you know, prevent wolves or something, and it starts with a B. So you know it's a B. So let me point out how this works. You gotta do that. Was that inside or outside? Okay, well, whatever. Anyway, so the answer should be kind of obvious to some people who have played certain games, because, I don't know, it just sort of made... It clicked in my head for me when I'd first played. How did you find this? So anyway, one of the things about the code, though, is one of the other things talks about what vowels it has. Anyway, this is an ancient hammer. This is also an ancient hammer. It's a stone hammer, technically. And this... This is our ballistic missile. So I'm gonna show this off, and I saved beforehand for some reasons. Let me just show you what happens here. It's basically the same effect as though you were a mech combat and you fired off the rocket. Yeah, yeah, look at how far everything goes. Whoa, look at that thing. Oh, pieces of zombie everywhere. So it's just kind of a for fun item. It's not really a beefy type item. Man, that gets some distance. It hit the wall even. Dang. I love this weapon. I would love to keep this. I actually need to keep this, maybe. That would make things easier, wouldn't it? So anyway, you don't really need this weapon, but I'm going to hold on to it. I'm not actually going to restart because I kind of need this now that I think about it. It only took a little bit of thinking, but I realized one very specific thing that it's probably going to help me with. So, yeah, our only issue, of course, is that now a lot of different things are alerted, which is kind of bad, but, you know, it's fine. Doesn't matter too terribly much. No, you don't. I wish I could hit them midair. That would be so cool. I'm pretty sure you can, I just don't know if anybody's really managed it. Okay, good. You're done. Goodbye. Can't get into the cathedral this time. I believe it is closed off completely to us. At this juncture, being an expert. I don't fully know how that works. I think it works where there's three different doors in the same position, and then they break depending on what difficulty you're in. They just get deleted. So, we're just gonna do the same thing we did last time, every time actually. Just gonna do it nice and easy. Make sure we got some supplies for our journey. Okay, thank you. So, let's go talk about the differences. As you can see, this area here has been pretty much the same every time we've been through it. Up to and including these zombies. Alright, so they are in fact still alerted, technically speaking, by the ballistic missile we let off. I mean, for good reason, we did set off a ballistic missile. I mean, you would think that would have some kind of effect. It is very loud, very noisy. It's basically a fire arrow. Not too much else to it. Let's see. Yeah, we can't go down to the church. We're completely barred off from that area now. That is the end of it. We cannot go that way anymore. Not allowed. Oh, hey, diamond. That's right, diamonds are on different difficulties. Different diamonds on different difficulties, even. So, yeah. I don't think we can go that way this time. Oh, no. This is the way we go. For some reason, I was thinking we had to go back down underground under the water again. Can I actually open this for once? Thank you. Instead of dancing around it like a fool. Okay. Oh boy, once more into the breach. For those of you who don't know what that means, I swear I can English. I promise. I promise I can English today. Alright then. Once more into the breach, usually referring to, what is it, the Battle of the Somme or something? Same note as usual. Hasn't changed. This has changed. We gotta pick this lock now. I don't think we had to pick this lock before, but we do now. Okay. Keeps doing that, and it's kind of annoying. Stop turning this way. I gotta, like, walk over here just to get you to turn differently. Okay. Oh. That works, too. Alrighty. Yeah. Did I ever show this off? I think I didn't. There you go. Fire everywhere. Burn the bodies. Roast them up. I'm sure they taste good with stew. Okay. So we can go ahead and shut off the valve. Nothing too terrible. I'll come back to that. lot of zombies in there now. I don't really want to deal with it, but I'm probably gonna have to. Just for the record. I heard that. How dare you leave me? Someone in there now? No, okay. Good. Excellent. I'll wait for him to come back. We don't have the entranceway. Little cutscene this time. Don't really know why, don't really understand why that trigger changed, but I'm kind of glad for it because we've already seen it twice, so. Yeah. What's up with you? You're a haunt. I don't like you. Thank you. Goodbye. Alright, well, we'll probably end up back there anyway, so let's go elsewhere. Can't open that. This is back. Yes, it will do the same trick again. This door's broken. It's over here now. This guy's back here. I'm just gonna grab this. All of these are the same. Right? Yeah, all of these are the same. So yeah. Not gonna bother with that. Hey. All this is the same. What's different is what's in here. I'm just kidding, it's exactly the same. You're like impossible to hit sometimes, I swear. Okay. If you stay down, I'll leave you alone. Promise. All bueno? Clearly not. Doesn't want to take my very generous offer of leaving him alone if he stays down. Okay, now what is it that's doing that? Because that's actually kind of weirding me out a little bit. It was like a... Because I had stopped pressing buttons, but I was still apparently going forward, but like... I don't know, it just felt bouncy. It was weird. Anything in here? No. Nothing in there. Who is making those noises? Clearly it must be you.
Flames around you, flames, nothing but flames burning your flesh. Flames around you, flames, nothing but flames burning your
flesh. So yeah, that's how mud arrows work. I don't think I'd shown that off yet. It's kind of neat. This is the other side of that one area. This is why I was talking about I may have to kill them. That's right. This guy is down here too. That's why. So anyway, that's the problem with the zombies. Kill them up there, that guy's gonna be totally alert and is not gonna be happy about it. Anyway, there's a lot of zombies up there. I could use a ballistic missile. I could, but I'm not going to because that would be kind of dumb. I mean, it's not really dumb, it's genius, but I'd alert everything within a 15-mile radius. And I don't really want to do that right this second, so... Therefore, somebody's door closed. Hey, this guy's not here anymore. And now there's loot there. But this guy is coming through again. He's still here. Hey, differences. Also, I hear them. Wherever it is. Thanks. Okay, yeah, they're coming through again. No? What were the footsteps then? I could have sworn that was, No. Let me in. Let me in. I don't wanna... I don't wanna make him mad. Okay. Yeah, I noticed that. Huh. It's getting really kind of annoying, actually. I'll explain later, I suppose. Okay, so I don't know what's up with this one, but the barrels are gone that were here. I don't really know why, they're just not here anymore, so... yeah. Okay. Yeah, it's all the same. Near as I can tell, that's all the same, so... what is that? Like, I think it's just me having some weird kind of, like, keyboard lag or something. I don't know. It's weird, and I don't like it. Nope. Okay. So, that was a clue, and now I cannot drop the clue, actually. It's a clue to the code. It does not use I, O, or U. It does not use any of those vowels. So... that should go a long way towards helping you figure out the code if you hadn't already. I think before that point there's something said about what it rhymes with or something. But don't quote me on that. I'm not really like 100% sure what the actual other clue code was. I'm ready for it this time. Yeah, I remembered this time. Can't get me. Where... this guy seems to always be alerted. What happened to your face? Anyway, this guy seems to always be alert. That's totally my fault. He is actually 100% alert right now. Good to know. I don't really like this turn of events. Can you maybe go back to your normal patrol? Why is he going in there? Seems like an odd place to go. I knew his patrol changed. I knew it. I didn't do anything about it, but I knew it. That's the one thing I do like about the difficulty changes, is that their patrols actually do change. Oh god, there's another. Let me take my new buddy, Mr. Skullface. And we'll just hang out with Mr. Bloody over here. Alright then. You have fun searching for us. I'm just gonna hide behind this desk. Oh, wait, no, okay. I thought that was something, but it's just his foot. Well, I guess I'll just be... why does that keep happening? Do you guys know what's sitting at the bottom of the screen? When it keeps happening? I've seen it happen with the save text, too. It will, like, re-pop it up when I do something. I don't understand. I'm pretty sure it's 1.23 that's doing it. And it's kind of annoying, but not enough for me to, like, actually complain about it anywhere. Except for here. Because, honestly, by the time it matters, and the fact that it's really just, like, a visual problem, I lost my train of thought right there, so. Alright, secrets. Ha-ha! Now he is pleading with his god, because he hid jewelry, and he's not supposed to. Holding out on us, you tapper. Yes, nectarines. In case you didn't know, they are actually talking about nectarines. Demonic nectarines. Okay. Everyone knows that demons love nectarines. Also, the demons are lawful entities. Bet you didn't know that. Technically speaking. Little Timmy's still here. Still gonna take this piece. Still not gonna let Little Timmy loose. Nor am I gonna free him from his cursed afterlife. These two are still hanging out. Mr. Dolphin over there. Hello? Alright, passcode, key, hint, telling you what it rhymes with. Hey, it starts with a B, rhymes with some stuff. I hate you so much. And I knew you were there, too, because that's the only one of the three I remember. kill you every time. Stop looking at me. Anyway, I love that zombie. It's a nice touch. Yeah. So, you will wait until after you pass under it, if you go the other way, but you know how that goes. There we go. Just want to grab all this good stuff. So you can see the War Gauntlet is not in this location this time. I didn't show it off last time. Maybe I will this time. It's not terribly important or interesting. So that's why I didn't bother. But I do need this loot here. And the note is still here. And it's the same note. And it's the same note. And nobody wants to reread that note because it's the same note. Alright. Nothing wrong with that. Just letting you know it's the same note. And because it's the same note, I'm not going to stick too long on it. I'm not going to flip through it. Because I know it's the same note. Because it's always the same note. Okay. Where are we, gentlemen? We are here. In this spooky, spooky place. Where a lot of people have died. Just want to grab that real quick. I can get it. Wait, it's not there right now. Oh, no, it is. Perfect. It had nothing in it this time. Good to know. Same note, I think. Yeah, same note. Same note. Same note. I have razorhead arrows. That's interesting. What are those for? Okay, I'm gonna ignore that. Spooky. Spooky, spooky stuff. It's just you. It's you guys again. Yeah, yeah.
I crumble.
This looks like the way in.
Yeah. I'm trying to remember what differences there are. Spooktastic? Dang it. I didn't change weapons soon enough. Well, I hope there's only one following me, but knowing my luck, it's gonna be both of them. Oh, are you stuck there? Can you not come this way? Ow. You're not supposed to be able to do that, you jerk. Well, I suppose I might as well just reload. Because this is pretty much impossible to do. They're very good sword fighters. Didn't you know? Yeah, I should probably just restart. Well, you know, he's dead now, so. Guess it's fine. What was that noise? Oh, just somebody slamming doors. Got it. Totally unrelated to the game events, just FYI. It's neighbors. Neighbors are fun. Hey! You're not supposed to do that. You know you're not supposed to do that. You're not supposed to react before I hit you. That's just plain unsporting. Anyway, let's go get our stuff. This is here now. This is here before. And I feel kind of like someone who just went insane a little bit. Because I realized that there's things here and I'm like, oh, is that always there? Is that there before? What's that doing here? It's like somebody moved things around my house when I wasn't looking. It's kind of what it feels like anyway. No, you don't see me. That would be silly. You have 8 eyes. You can't see me. Anytime I pick up a piece of loot, the saved up at the top thing, the text, just sort of pops up for some reason. Kind of weird. Anything in there? No. Hi! I thought he was going the other way. Okay, you go to sleep. Oh, hey, this is new. Tunnels? Exploration? What's going on here? Are you gonna be mad if I just, like, walk up there? Because I'm kind of getting tired of having to wind arrow everything. Yes, true. I don't actually know how to pronounce that. Hi. You weren't actually supposed to turn around, you know. Perfect. Says the exact same thing it always does. Nothing's changed here at all, actually. The only reason I come this way is because it's easier. The other way is exactly the same as last time, too. No. You saw nothing. Nothing is different. Everything is the same. Spooky bastards. Alright. Yeah. Got you now. Come on, go get me. You know you want to. They're coming to get you, Barbara. Anyway. I guess I'll just hang out in here for a while. Did I lose a lot of health somewhere? After that, healing potion I took? What damage did I take? Maybe that haunt apparition did actually manage to... Well, it's red and strange. Come on. I just want you guys to come closer. That way I can actually hit you. Don't know which one I'm hitting right now. There we go, this works. Other way, thank you. Thank you, Garrett. Please aim through the wall. Perfect. So I may have been standing too close to a zombie at some point because I lost some health. I don't know where or when. I'm just gonna do what I did last time. I should go somewhere very specific before continuing, which is the reason why I came this way in the first place. To the bar.
I see you have come this far, young thief. I knew you would find me here.
Knew I would come? But
if it is the Book of Secrets that you seek, you must first obtain the four stones of the pagan rituals. But each stone has a guardian, a tyrant of pagan magic. Your journey will not be easy. The guardians cannot be harmed by ordinary means.
You've got to be kidding me.
Do you wish to help me?
Nope.
But you have no choice, thief. You need the stones to gain access to the book. And I need revenge for my fallen comrades. We did not fight the guardians, but it is the guardians who represent the power of this Manse. Defeat them, and I shall aid you with the magics I have discovered here. Bring me their heads, and the power of my wisdom you shall have. Remember, thief, a blade harms not that which is concealed by metal. The holy powers of the builder are strongest in the air, and fire illuminates that which cannot be seen.
All right, old man.
Oh, is that it? Okay, there we go. Thank you for letting me know we have a new objective. Let's find out what it says. If what Ramis says is true, you'll need to find three more stones before you can steal the core book of magic. But he's asked for your help in exchange for this information. Aid the ghost of Ramis by bringing him the heads of the three guardians. You choose to trust him, he gave you... Okay. So we do actually need his help anyway. You have no choice about this. Anyway, we gotta drop the heads in here, that's what it's for. Kinda glossed over that last time, cause wasn't time for that. Wasn't sure if he showed up on the medium difficulty, normal, hard, expert. Yeah. Yes. I can count. Count with words. Anyway, it's still so gross. Anyway, we gotta kick some butt, steal some heads. Totally didn't remember that that one guy would show up on hard. I thought he was an expert only thing because we kind of need his head to give to Ramus. Ramus gives us supplies. Is his name Ramus or Rasmus? Wait. Here already? Yeah, I suppose that's normal. I'll come back here. I need some supplies before I even bother with that. Alright, so there's four dudes? Something like that. Hey, it's a note. It's probably the same note it was last time. Yeah, same note from last time. This part, actually, I really do feel is kind of weird. Just wanted to point this out, before I completely ignore it. Where did that go? It just seems kind of weird to me that there are two different ways down here, all things considered. This is supposed to be- I know I grabbed it! Where is it? The empty vial. I know I had it. You can't tell me I didn't have it. I know it's either in my inventory or gone. You can't just do that to me. Alright. I don't know where it went. Apparently it's not going to show up. Regardless of all the tricks I use to normally have things show up in my inventory when they aren't showing up. Just try this again. Come on. Where is it? I know it exists. I know it's in my inventory. I know I picked it up. Okay, well, that's going to be frustrating. I hope it didn't break because I know I already saved over it anyway, so that's going to suck. Anyway, there's these guys. They're kind of jerks. This is the War Gauntlet again. Let's grab it. Because why not? Ha ha! Did you see what happened there? Did you see that? Clearly you didn't because you're not reacting to it. Alright then. You're steadily getting more angry, I can tell. Can you maybe turn the other way, though? I forgot what I was talking about. I was talking about my vial being sick for one. Can't think. I do really find it hard to think when I keep hearing, like, flames around us, flames! Burning our flesh. Okay, thanks for that. What was I talking about? Four guys? Three guys? Five guys? Sounds tasty. Note. Lots of notes in this one. Lots of cool stuff. Lots of backstory. What on earth was I talking about? Lost my train of thought and now it's gone forever. War Gauntlet. War Gauntlet is awesome. Oh, this guy, by the way. You know, I'm gonna do this just to show it. Yeah, I see you, thief. That's me. Are you alright? See, the head is smart, body not so much. This isn't one of the heads I pick up? This is not one of the heads I pick up. Got it. Got it under control, coach. What's this way? This is the other way? Yeah, this is the other way. Nothing too terribly important down that way, so I'm just gonna ignore it. This is not one of the heads I need to pick up, apparently. I kinda thought it was for some reason. Probably because he mentioned heads, and it's a head that's just kinda there. Anyway, I just wanna show how cool it was that he sees you, and it alerts him, you know, from there. I think what's actually happening is that there's two entities in that equation. So yeah. Just gonna hang out in here. Sweet library you got, guys. I'm just here for the, nothing behind here? Really? I don't even even know what that says. Anyway, I do find it hard to think sometimes when the Haunts are doing their thing, talking about murder and nectarines and, you know, things like that. Something about their forge and... Yeah. It's kind of hard to concentrate occasionally. Please turn around. I'm just getting tired of you. Anyway, War Gauntlet is awesome. It does kill them, I think. But I think it does it quieter than normal. It's the only difference, I think. So that makes it a pretty awesome item. Anyway, we need to get some gems. Hi. I like how you didn't react to me, but you're kind of reacting to the corpse, and now you're reacting to me? Yeah, whatever. I'll just leave him there. That's fine. I'm good with that. Oh, right! The vial! Where the hell did it go? How is it just gone? I mean, the good news is I really don't think I actually need it, but... It's rather frustrating because I had it, and now I don't. And it's not an item that can be dropped, so I don't know how I would have lost it. Either way, I thought I needed something first, but that's alright then. Wait, okay. Guards in the skies. The five of flight with fires and magics of blight to kill the beastesses to protect our stone of Manse thoughts. So, these things are different now, by the way. Watches the black, watches the night, stands the demon to chase away light. Yeah, he's right there, by the way. He's kind of an asshole, gonna be honest. And, well... Just gonna point this out. Just save right there. Yep, nothing doing. Completely immune. Just gotta remember how this works. To that point, though, I believe you can kill him by taking out the torches or something, but no point in it. I'm just gonna take the stone and be gone. Wait a minute. I do need to kill you. Totally forgot. I get rewards for killing you. Right? 1, 2, 3? I think? Was this the answer? No, I actually think... Oh, that's right, ballistic missiles. Sure! I love ballistic missiles. Ow. Okay, that's right. That was a dumb thing to do. It was funny nonetheless. I shot a ballistic missile in his face. I'm gonna do it again, too. Oh, hey. Accidentally pressed F2 and F5 at the same time! Sometimes that breaks the game. Don't do that. And ka-chunk. Ballistic missile to the face. Now he's on fire. I'm not really sure what's about to happen here. I'm hoping he'll drop his head. Because that's kind of the only outcome I can see happening. Are you, you good? Do you need a fireman? See, he's taking damage animations, I just don't know if he's actually taking damage. Oh, there he goes. Dead. Hey, there's his head. Thank you. Ugh. So nasty. Alright, well, we got him to shut up, so... That's all I care about. Just gonna go drop this off real quick, see what I get out of it, because I believe I will need it for the third guy. Guardian head. Gonna put you in the stew pot.
Excellent.
Yes. What is this? Potion of life breath. That's new. Gonna try it, because I don't remember what it does, but, life breath? I feel like I shouldn't use them unless I know what they're gonna do, though. So I'm not actually gonna use it, which is kind of dumb, I know, but... well, that's how I feel. Okay, so... well... might as well go deal with this guy. What? So yeah, you can see it's different now. There's a statue there. And ka-chunk. I killed myself. Accidentally killed myself. It's the best. You can't help but make noise here, cause it's kind of a dick like that. The only thing we can do is hit him with our sword, really. No, you look really gross up close. You got like this massive overbite, and it kind of reminds me of ducks. Ew. It's all like corpse parts. Mind stone. Alright, well, we got another head. Let's go put it in the pot. See what we get. Gotta mix it up. Gotta get some life breath. Yeah. I don't remember what these potions do, and I don't remember where the book is that tells me what they do.
You have done well.
He's invisible when he does those things? Weapons Bane. None of this makes sense. I promise it will never make sense, but that's okay. I know that there is a book that describes exactly what the potions do, and you're supposed to use that, but I don't actually know. Rides the beastesses, does the demon of flesh, and into his flesh nothing can touch, cloaked in the metal of earth that flakes the blade. What did he say? He said something about the fact that metal cannot something cloak. I don't remember what he told me, but he gave me a word of wisdom before he disappeared, the ghostly guy. And, said something about how, thanks for that, by the way. Fleshstone? Awesome. Was it Weapons Bane? Maybe. I'm pretty sure there was- anyway, he's basically got- what the heck are you- okay. Yeah, anyway, as long as he's riding this Burrick, he's totally safe. Don't really know why, but he is. So, make it so that he's not riding the Burrick. Then he gets back up again, and he's like, what the heck? Who killed my mount? And then I'm all like, ballistic missile to the face. Anyway, you can see why I kept on to that ballistic missile. I thought about it and was like, yeah, I'm gonna want it. Because otherwise you have to use your sword and that potion in conjunction. And doing that, not fun. Just gonna let you know that right now. It takes a lot of hits to deal with, and it's kind of frustrating. This door's open. It doesn't open the same way. You could have gone in there first, I think, technically. But we did need the gemstones, so now we have those, and it's all bueno. All good. Let's go see what we get.
Well done.
I think my work here is done.
Potion of the Firewalker. I believe this is something that prevents me from dying in fires. Hooray! Don't remember what all these things do. Don't remember where the readme is that tells me what they do. Alright, so let's go hang out down here where there's lava and stuff that's gonna be firing at us because, hey, look, Burricks! Okay, what have I got? Flesh. Go somewhere. There you go. See, they're just kind of here, so I'm not even, like, gonna try avoiding them. Gonna be honest about that. There's really no point in it. They're just perks. Nothing too terribly special. Mind. Spirit, where are you? There you go. You have a new objective. What is our new objective? Steal the Tome of Spells. Don't forget to pick them up on the way out. And then exit. Exit's over there. Just like last time. Gonna ignore all their bullshit. Yep, thanks for that. I am in danger of death. Thank you. Glad I'm not dead. I didn't realize I was quite so low on health. When did that happen? That seems to be a common theme today. Anyway, exit's up here.
The book I managed to get my hands on seems to be pretty important, the way the undead were guarding it. It should be just the key to finding out more about the history of this stone, once I get it translated. Getting my hands on it was a lot more trouble than I expected, and I'm hoping this will be the end of my little quest. The last thing I want to do is wander through more dark caverns full of haunts and zombies. Now that I'm back on the surface, it's time to get out of this hellhole and get in touch with somebody who can make sense of this tome.
Okay, ending is exactly the same as per usual. Still took 40 minutes. Each time I play, it gets a little bit shorter because we've already gone through the area. Anyway, 1629 out of 1904, I still miss the secret and I don't know where the other one is. Oops. I actually don't know what the second secret is. I know that first secret is the vault itself. Perhaps the second one is finding something. I could be wrong about that. I don't actually know. Anyway, yeah, we did a lot of damage to stuff because there was a lot of stuff to kill. And, that's the inverted manse. We did everything. Like, everything you can possibly do in it. And I didn't do too half-terrible on the loot either, so I'm kind of happy about that. So that said, I'll be moving to the review portion momentarily.